Namaste, good evening, bonsoir. I'm Sri Lakshmi Sudhish Kumar, the Festival Ambassador of the Great India Festival and your MC for this evening. With great honor and pride, I welcome you all to Mahabharat Utsav, day two of the grand finale celebrations of TGIF's 10th anniversary. The Great India Festival has been recognized as one of the top 40 cultural festivals in North America. And it's supported by passionate volunteers, festival partners, and sponsors. Our mission is to offer our global visitors a world-class opportunity to experience and personally learn about the traditions, culture, and heritage of India, and thus promote multicultural understanding, appreciation, harmony, and peace, and enhance intercultural connectivity in Canada. As you all know, the year 2020 has been a challenging year for all of us. But despite the challenges, TGIF has delivered virtual programming this year. As a part of the 10th anniversary celebrations, we have successfully hosted several events, including the Shojwala series, Bharatotsav International Competition, Mahavasantotsav, Samanvaya, Yoga Summit in Canada, and Multiculturalism Day. Let us begin today's show, day two of grand finale Mahabharat Utsav 2021 by lighting of the lamp. Light is a universal symbol of truth, knowledge, and understanding. It acts as a guide and keeps us from stumbling in the dark. Keeping up with our age-old tradition, the festival begins with a ceremonial symbolic lighting of the lamp. The lamp is invoked as Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, meaning lamp leads us from darkness towards light. To commence this ceremony, on behalf of TGIF, I welcome Srimati Anju and Dr. Somesh Bhargava to light the lamp and grace this occasion. Sir.
Om Shubham Karoti Kalyanam Arogyam Dhan Sampada Shatru Vinashaya Deepa Jyoti Namostute. तत्र सूर्यो भान्ति न चंद्र तारकं भीमा विद्युतो भान्ति कुतो यम अग्नि त्वमेव भान्ति मन भान्ति सर्वं तस्य भासा सर्व इदं नमा
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. It's my pleasure to welcome Honorable Lisa McLeod, Minister of Heritage, Sport, Tourism, and Culture Industries, to say a few words for our audience today.
Thank you so much. It's great. Thank you so much. It's great to be here with you virtually. Obviously, I usually love to be with you in person to celebrate over the past 10 years. And I want to congratulate all of you for keeping this festival, this very important festival, both to the city of Ottawa, as well as to the broader province of Ontario going, particularly during COVID-19. And I know that many of you would like to celebrate in person, and we're going to get to that spot very soon. I want to say thanks to all of those of Indo-Canadian descent in the riding of Nepean, which I represent, but also throughout the rest of Ontario, who make this event so special and who have made it so special during the last decade. As many of you know, I had the opportunity to travel to India, and I talk about that quite frequently. In fact, just yesterday, when I was in Barrie speaking to an Indo-Canadian couple, talking about my time both in Kerala and Mumbai and Delhi and Uttar Pradesh and so many other parts, and what a wonderful experience that was. And you know, we'll be able to do those travels again one day, and we'll be able to welcome even more of those folks from India back to our country as it gets safer. But today, I think, is a very important day. We're celebrating your 10 years. You're on day two, and I'm just really excited that I was able to, as Minister of Heritage, Sport, Tourism and Culture Industries, but also as your local MPP, invest $38,000 into this festival to make sure that not only could it go on without a hitch, but that we would be able to support it in years in the future and to make sure that you're sustainable and you have an ability to thrive and to move forward. And I want to say this just before I conclude. I was thinking about this the other day. Many of us really miss and have loved Hunts Deep Ranger. And I can tell you one of the first calls I made when I was a new minister in this portfolio was to let him know that we were funding the South Asian Fest. And I've been thinking about him a lot lately because, as many of you know, Hunts Deep was a great community leader, a great organizer. Of course, he had his show. And so whenever I think of a great event that celebrates the culture of Indo-Canadians, I think of him. And so I just wanted to say that tonight. And you know, to be here with the lamp lighting, to look at hope and what's ahead. We certainly all need that during these times, but I wanted to recognize him, all of you. And you know what, this time next year, I cannot wait to be with you all. And I know many of you have danced with me in the past and taught me to dance. I'll be doing that as well. And hopefully I'll be able to don one of my saris again. So thank you all very much. Very proud of you. And again, couldn't be more excited, not only as your MPP, but locally as minister, to be able to invest $38,000 into this wonderful festival. So good luck, and here's to 10 more years.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your kind words and encouragement. We are really grateful for your support, and we hope to have it in the future too. Thank you so much for coming and for your precious time. Thank you. Dr. Somesh Bhargava is from Jaipur, and he studied at St. Xavier's School, then attended medical school also in Jaipur. He arrived in Canada in 1968, qualified as a pediatrician from the Hospital for Sick Children, Toronto. He has lived and worked in Ottawa since 1974. Dr. Bhargava's introduction to Sanatan Dharma was through his father and various Dharmacharyas who frequently visited him, not only in India, but continue to do so here in Ottawa. With that short introduction, may I please request Dr. Someshwar Bhargava to speak a few words for us. Sir, we are unable to hear you.
Honorable Lisa McLeod, Minister of Heritage, Sports, Tourism and Culture, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the TGIF, it's my privilege to thank the various participants and specifically Madam McLeod. You've always been have always participated in most of Indo-Canadian events in the NCR. And now with your today's announcement, you have further proven how and where your support lies when it comes to multiculturalism, heritage, and activities in the National Capital Region. Madam, though the Indo-Canadians come from an area which is geographically far away, actually on the other side of the globe, but philosophically, we are both on the same page. The multiculturalism, multilingualism, multi-faith, all these are words and practices with which every Indian grew up with. And as such, we find ourselves very much at home here. And as I say, geographically different, but philosophically very much akin. One being an, the elder sister of the other. So thank you so much for being here and giving us support. And we look forward to your support in the future as well. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your kind words of encouragement and enlightening words. Thank you. Thank you, Srimati Anju, for your time and support as well. Now we are going to move on to our programs. But before that, I will be saying a few words about today's program. TGIF has become a landmark event in the nation's capital. Due to its dedicated volunteers, magnificent and spectacular performances by renowned artists, TGIF to date has hosted hundreds of music, dance, and performing art shows, more than 200 workshops, 100 plus art exhibits, and also sponsorships support from over 100 organizations. TGIF provided strong encouragement and a platform for numerous budding as well as established talented Canadian artists. We wholeheartedly thank our festival partners and sponsors who play an important role in the success of all our programs. Thank you, festival partners, Ontario Ministry of Heritage, Sport, Tourism and Cultural Industries, Canadian Heritage, City of Ottawa, and High Commission of India for their support through grants. I take this opportunity to thank our sponsors. Our gold sponsors are Phoenix Homes and Kilika. Our culinary partners are Thali, Coconut Lagoon, and Indian Curry and Kebab House. Our media partners are CKCU FM, Asian Sounds, and CBC. Our cultural partners are Canadian Centre Mindful Habitats and SSDM. And our community partner is Indo-Canadian Community Center. We'll be playing a short video thanking our festival partners. Stay tuned. Today, we have some amazing talents performing for you for the grand finale celebrations for TGIF's 10th anniversary. We are on day two of the Mahabharat Utsav 2021. Are you ready to experience a beautiful journey through dance, music, culture, and heritage of India? Today, in addition to all the extraordinary programs, we have included a series of dance performances for your enjoyment. Dances of India series will feature various dance performances from the western part of India. I'm excited and curious to watch and learn more about these dance forms. Hope you're all too. Let us start the show with Pushpanjali, a Bharatanatyam performance. Bharatanatyam is an Indian classical dance form that originated from temples of Tamil Nadu. The name Bharatanatyam is known to be derived from its foundational elements, bhava, meaning expression, raga, meaning melody, tala, rhythm, and natya, meaning dance. Its theoretical basis can be traced to Sanskrit text on performing arts written by sage Bharata, called Natya Shastra. According to the legends, gods and goddesses requested the creator, Lord Brahma, to create a fifth Veda that can be easily understood by common man. Honoring their request, He created Natyaveda using lyrics from Rigveda, music from Samaveda, gestures from Yajurveda, and emotions and aesthetics from Atharva Veda. He taught this to the sage Bharata, who scribed it as Natya Shastra. The Bharatanatyam dancer uses combination of rhythmic footwork, graceful body movements, and gestures and expressions to narrate stories that spark and engage the observer's imagination and convey deep spiritual ideas. Traditionally, it is accompanied by Carnatic music. Today, we have Riya Mittal performing for us Pushpanjali. She's a teacher with Edmonton Public School District. She has been training as an Indian classical dancer both in Kathak and Bharatanatyam under the guidance of her grandmother, Usha Gupta. She has performed in Usha Dance Entourage Productions, Nari Nari Nari, My Love in 2007, Alap 2014 to 2017, and Coach 2018 to 2020. Presented by Brian Webb Dance Company, who also presented Riya's production, Urja, Love That Ignites in 2019. In 2017, she completed her Ranga Pravesh, which is the dance graduation, a milestone in every dancer's career. Additionally, Riya studies contemporary dance with University of Alberta Orchestra's Dance Performance Group. Riya Mittal will be performing Pushpanjali, which is choreographed by Sandhya Kiran Subramanyam. Hope you all like it. Thank you, Riya Mittal, for that beautiful performance. It's a great start for our programs today. Next up, we have a documentary on Varanasi toys and toys heritage. ShoppingCart24.com is a global platform to many Indian viewers, artisans, craftsmen, farmers, and manufacturers. It is providing an online channel to showcase the unique and versatile line of Indian geographical indication products, and hence promoting richness and uniqueness of Indian arts and crafts. This is an online platform which comprises of more than 13,000 products, inclusive of 299 GI product categories out of the 370 registered GI product categories till date, providing the customers a wide variety of unique products through 1,600 plus authentic vendors on board. Today, we are going to watch the original documentary by the artisans of Varanasi. Sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Varanasi, older than history, spiritual and pious city of India, has been a center of attraction for centuries. It is not merely a geographical location, rather it's a living illustration depicting the key concepts of human existence as dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Apart from these larger than life concepts, it has been the focal point of arts and artistry. The lanes of Varanasi is flavorful, colorful and aesthetic as well. It contains the essence of vast culture and tradition of human civility with artistic expressions. It is my pleasure to introduce one of the oldest and a pure Varanasi art which has unaltered and reverent. It is none other than Varanasi wooden lacquerware and toys. Varanasi has been one of the largest toy making center in India, and the city has been practicing this traditional craft for many generations. According to the sources, the artisans believed that lacquer toys started when a ruler of Rajasthan state was descended by the Mughal emperor. Supporters of the previous ruler, the common people, had to leave their houses and start a livelihood in the forest. To earn for their families, people started making wooden toys and selling them to the king and in the market. In this craft, only local wood sourced like mahua, mango, eucalyptus, kima, chilbil, aldu. Locals say that earlier sesame wood were used in making these toys, but due to dearness, cheaper and lighter wood is sourced now. For making these toys, the wood block as per the size of the toy to be made is cut from the log. The piece is cleaned and sanded to get a smooth surface. The design of the toy to be made is traced on the piece. Extra wood is chipped off according to the design. Fine strokes with the hammer are made on the chisel to give shape to the wood piece. It is again smoothened with a file. Sometimes the whole toy is carved out from a single piece of wood, whereas in some cases different body parts are carved separately and joined together with adhesive. Each wooden piece that is cut to make an item is subjected to a process of slow heating to draw out all moisture. After wood carving, wood turning is the next process. Wood turning involves using a lathe to create objects from wood. As the lathe turns, the wood remains in the same position and slowly is shaped. Using this basic process, it is possible to create many different objects from wood, including some designs that are intricate in detail. It is of two types: spindle turning, that involves using wood where the grain runs in the same direction as the lathe bit. Second is faceplate turning, in which the wood grain runs vertical to the rotation of the lathe. Workshops are set up with turning machines powered by electricity. Around 5 to 10 craftsmen work together in a single workshop. Wooden logs cut in small pieces using a saw. After this, they are brought here and fit into the machine. First, the machine peels off the outer rough skin to give a cylinder with a smooth surface, which is further used to give required shape with the help of skilled craftsmen. This work requires a proper observation of the artist. They cut the wood logs, and after cutting, carving, they tried to fix the each wood logs for getting the desired shape of toys. In the video, you can see the artisan is cutting the wood logs and trying to give the shape of auto rickshaw, which is very popular in India. After fixing, again they smoothen the surface of toys and this will help to get a proper and fine shape of the toy. In the video, the artisan is showing the final wooden auto rickshaw without coloring. After carving and lacquering, painting is done. Vivid colors are used to paint the body. For painting, the brushes made of squirrel's tail are used for fine work. Final touch is done by the kevda leaf, which is pressed over the wood while turning it and polish the product. Clean varnish is used to give a finished look to the final product. Varanasi Wooden Lacquerware and Toys received the geographical indication tag in 2015. Wooden utensils, spinning tops, birds, animals, butterflies, complete sets of orchestra, dolls of all shapes and sizes, furnitures are very popular in this category. These beautiful toys also depict social life, rural activities, religious inferences, as well as traditional Indian motifs and culture. It is very heartwarming to see these hugely popular sustainable wooden toys are in great demand in India and exported to various parts of the world in large quantities. A tremendous variety of wooden toys are made in Varanasi, which can be classified into different categories, namely cultural, religious, traditional, animals, birds, and modern toys. In each theme, the toys are treated in different manner. If we consider religious toys, they are predominantly two-dimensional, carved with hand and painted gaudily. They showcase Indian patterns and motifs. These toys depict mythical and pious stories of the past. If we look at the cultural theme toys, they depict different classes of society, the daily activities and lifestyle of the people in pastoral India, and also some ancient professions which are popular, as women going to well to draw water from it and men wrestling in the ground. The modern toys are predominantly three-dimensional, which are made by turning and showcase modern themes and patterns. A very popular line, give children toys that are powered by their imagination, not by batteries. Toys remain the inseparable part of every child's life, but unfortunately, present-day kids are not getting them in their hands. Toys depict the imagination, creativity and innocence of a child's mind. Do not replace it with modern day gadgets. Let your child grow as you, because that is where the true essence of childhood lies. Give your child his childhood. Give him Varanasi wooden lacquerware and toys.
That is a great initiative and a very informative documentary. Please support them by visiting their website, www.shoppingcart24.com, and that will be and try purchasing some good wooden toys and other artifacts and support these craftsmen. Thank you. Thank you so much for that great documentary. Next up, we have Dreams of Fire by Upasana Spirit of Dance. This is Kathak meets Flamenco, a fusion dance from the Upasana Spirit of Dance, where Ghungru and Flamenco shoes come live together in our August festival by Dreams of Fire. Kathak is one of the Indian classical dance forms. It involves storytelling through dance. It's a mix of music, dance, and drama, creating an elegant form of dance. Dreams of Fire is a blend of traditions. Both dance styles, Flamenco from Spain and Kathak from India, share similar dance concept with each other. Both styles use similar rhythm. The foot movements weave together as one, following the sound of the instrument, while their arm movements and upper body resemble one another. Life is filled with passion, religious, romantic, artistic. And those passions burn within us like indomitable fire. And this piece explores that fire with the power of dance. Brought to life by Upasana, the Spirit of Dance, professional dance company, it features original music and talented performers by Savita, Sunita, Karina, Nikita, Megha, Shilpa, and Rashmi. TGIF presents to you Dreams of Fire, a unique dance performance you don't want to miss.
Where the hand moves, the glance follows. Where the glance goes, the mind follows. Where the mind goes, imagination follows. And where imagination goes, understanding and harmony are created.
Dhin, dhin, dha. Hin nadan, Take it.
That was spectacular choreography and a brilliant performance by the Upasana, the Spirit of Dance Professional Dance Company. Thank you so much for that program. And now I just wanted to say that as a part of the 10th anniversary celebrations, we decided to go with 10 beautiful themes, the dances of India from North, South, East, and West. And we have women exclusive programs with who are experts in rare musical instruments. And then we have popular vocal artists from India. We have award winner recipients of Padma Shri like Gopal Prasad Dubey, then Sangeeta Nataka Academy awardees, and also exquisite music ensembles by Grammy Award nominee like Pandit Subhain Chatterjee. And then we have special programs like Sing Along Chef, a unique combination of food and music in 6 different languages with Chef Sachin from Curry and Kebab House and singers from Ottawa. This will basically give you a real festive feel on a virtual platform with music and food side by side. We also have Mumbai style recipes from Chef Pradeep. We are also featuring heritage documentaries on Banaras saris, Varanasi toys, Varanasi Meenakari art, and special folk dances from India. It also includes panel discussions by national and international thinkers. The art of painting live to a music concert are also a part of these great themes that we have chosen for you. These themes are very, very carefully picked to give the viewers the best experience of the festival on a virtual platform. Hopefully, we can enjoy all these in person in the future. Let's all hope and pray for a in-person festival next year. We now move on to the Dances of India series featuring the dances from Western India. First in line is the Bhawai Ghumar. Bhawai is a genre of folk dance popular in Rajasthan state in Western India. The male and female performers balance a number of earthen pots or brass or metal pitchers as they dance nimbly, pirouetting and then swaying with the soles of their feet perched on top of a glass bottle, on the edge of a sword or rim of brass or metal thali plate, and on broken glass during the performance. The dance form consists of veiled dancing women balancing up to 22 brass metal pitchers on their head with lit fire, up to 9 pitchers as they dance. There is a sense of cutting edge suspense and nail biting acts in this dance. The accompaniment to the dance is provided by male performers singing melodious songs and playing a number of musical instruments, which include pakhwaj, dholak, Janjar, Sarangi, and Harmonium. Bhawai Ghumar performance today is brought to you by Jawahar Group from Jaipur. The performers are Kanchi, Mohita, Jawahar, and Tej.
बिजड़ा चमकावे गोरी थारिया, घूंघट में बिजड़ा चमकावे गोरी थारिया। मत जो वन में आंधी हो री नीचा, न तो झांक जरा सो जरा सो जरा सो ऊंचो लल गोरी पल्लो भीग जावे लो, जरा सो ऊंचो लल गोरी पल्लो भीग जावे लो।
Thank you, Jawahar Group, for that amazing performance. It was such a treat to watch. In our series of Dance of India from the West, we present to you the Lavani folk. Lavani folk is a genre of music popular in Maharashtra, India. Lavani is a combination of traditional song and dance, which particularly performed on beats of dolki, a percussion instrument. Lavani is noted for its powerful rhythm. Lavani has contributed substantially to the development of Marathi folk theater. In Maharashtra and southern Madhya Pradesh, it's performed by female performers wearing 9-yard long saris. The songs are sung in very quick tempo with a beat. Let us watch beautiful Lavani dance performance by Mamta Abha Group, Pune. The performers are Mamta Abha, Megha, Koyal, and Pravi.
जीव जीवाला रात ओले मस्त अंगूरी रात प्याले मदनाच रूप सुंदरा जनु इंद्राची अप्सरा गुलजार नार देखनी नखरे लकटक चांदनी पिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा राया पिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा अन इश्काचा गुलखंद खिलवा मला पिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा राया पिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा अन इश्काचा गुलखंद खिलवा झुल्यात झुलवा राय फिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा अन इश्काचा गुलकंद खिलवा मला फिरतीच्या झुल्यात झुलवा अन इश्काचा गुलकंद खिलवा
I'm not afraid.
गुलकंद खिलवा
So
Thank you, Mamta Abha Group from Pune, for that power-packed performance. It was such a treat to watch. Next in line in our series of Dances of India from the West, we present to you Gujarati Garba folk. Garba, Rudra Dandiya, is from the dance which originates from the state of Gujarat in India. The name is derived from the Sanskrit term Garba, that means womb, and Deep, a small earthenware lamp. Many traditional Garbas are performed around centrally lit lamp or a picture of or statue of goddess Shakti. Traditionally, it is performed during the 9-day Hindu festival Navratri. Either the lamp, the Garba Deep, or an image of goddess Durga, also called as Amba, is placed in the middle of concentric rings as an object of veneration. Vikrant Group from Pune and its talented artists Vikrant, Manhar, Firoz, Jasina, and Saira will be performing the Garba folk dance for us today.
Let's go. कहो पुनमना चांदनी आज के हाथमनी हो
Thank you, Vikrant Group Pune, for that amazing performance. That was the last performance in today's series of Dances of India West Edition. For this evening. So before we go into thanking we have to go and thank our festival partners. On behalf of TGIF, I would wholeheartedly thank our festival partners and sponsors who are a very important factor in our journey and success. Thank you, festival partners, Ontario Ministry of Heritage, Sport, Tourism and Cultural Industries, Canadian Heritage, City of Ottawa, and High Commission of India for their support through grants. I take this opportunity to thank our sponsors. Our gold sponsors are Phoenix Homes and Kilika. Culinary partners are Thali, Coconut Lagoon, and India Curry and Kebab House. Media partners, CKCU-FM, Asian Sounds, and CBC. Cultural partners, Canadian Center, Mindful Habitats, and SSDM. Community partner, Indo-Canadian Community Center. With all the amazing performance, it's time for me to say goodbye for the evening. I hope each one of you enjoyed all the great performances for day two of Mahabharat Utsav 2021. It was indeed a treat to watch. The amount of effort, practice, and dedication that goes into these performances and programs are commendable. I would like to congratulate and thank all participants wholeheartedly for their performance and programs today. On behalf of all the volunteers, organizers, and performers of TGIF, I thank our guests for gracing this occasion with their presence and words of encouragement. We hope to have your continued support in the future. Thank you, Srimati Anju and Dr. Someshwar Bhargava, and Honorable Lisa McLeod, Minister of Heritage, Sport, Tourism, and Culture Industries. Last but not the least, I thank the patrons, artists, audience, sponsors, volunteers, IT team, program development team, and media team for being a strong part of TGIF's journey with their support and love to make the show a grand success. To one and all, thank you. A quick and friendly reminder about our events on Saturday and Sunday. Please do tune in for all the sessions. We have morning and afternoon sessions with lots of exciting programs. I can guarantee it'll be days filled with exceptional performances of classical dances, music, vocal, and many, many more performances. Please visit our website, www.tgif.ca, for more information and current updates. Wishing you all a fantastic week ahead, I am Sri Lakshmi Sudish Kumar, Festival Ambassador of TGIF, signing off. Stay safe, stay blessed. Shubh Ratri.